पेपर
डू इट अगेन
बॉक्स
यस
ओके
क्लिक
सर
यस
हाँ
गिव हाइट
देन हाइट हैव टू क्लिक हियर
हाँ
5 फीट
ओके
नॉट कमिंग अप
जस्ट प्रेस ऑल प्लस डब्ल्यू सो दैट यू दैट विल बी इनलार्ज ऑल प्लस डब्ल्यू
ऑल प्लस डब्ल्यू सर
यस जस्ट डू ऑल प्लस डब्ल्यू इट्स नॉट वर्किंग दैट
ओके सर करेक्ट सर
Perspective view is not enlarged or what? Perspective view, just all plus W so that the perspective will be enlarged.
Okay,
yes,
sir.
Yes, yes, yes. Now you got it. See, there is some height over there.
Yes, sir. 5 feet.
5 feet, no? So, is your problem solved or you need something else?
Okay, sir. Problem solved, sir. And if I import the AutoCAD file
okay.
and draw the wall of option end to end selecting sir
do it can you do it here how you end to end because if I can see I can explain you much better
import like this
okay
is it correct sir and this box option see sir the end point where I'm not getting now sir actually this end point
end point
so yeah. How to draw the box for it if I get the end point only I can draw now sir
No, there are two ways. I will tell you, no problem. You got how you know how to import the this AutoCAD file,
yes,
right?
Yes.
And
yes,
one and two things you have to do first. Bring it at near to your 0-0 axis at the center. Right now your CAD is away from the center, right? And second,
yes,
group it. Select, click and drag everything. Yes, select everything. No. Is box is selected escape w yes
okay,
selection
sir.
Mode now click and drag now group everything you know how to group right
no sir I don't
okay I will tell you no how to group the things okay no problem today we will discuss how we can import and how we can draw the model
okay sir
okay fine so let's start today's class. We'll cover your doubt on that one. Okay. Sasikaran, are you with us?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. So right now we seen Priyanka have some problems. So we'll cover that also in today's class. And I would like to ask if you have any doubt or anything to like share with us.
Yes. One second.
Okay.
Can you see my screen?
Yeah, I can see your screen. Yes. So what is the problem you are facing?
Myself.
Yes, Sasikaran, are you facing any problem?
I am okay with that.
You're okay now. You're not having any problem, right?
No issue.
Okay, fine. So I will continue the class then.
Yes, please.
Okay, fine. Today we'll see how we can modify the object. And first of all, let me solve Priyanka's problem first, and then we'll continue how to modify the shapes. Remember, here we have escaped how to modify and create this door and windows that we have escaped in last class. Today we'll cover that, how we can create door and windows, how we cut made modification in our solid object. Before that, I will try to cover up Priyanka's problem. See, I have a plan with me. Let me bring a small plan. Suppose this AutoCAD file I have, and I have to import in this Max. Simply, I will go to file and import, and from here I can do merge. Okay, this is one of the step. I will tell you in detail later on when I'm gonna explain to Sasikiran also. As of now, quickly I'm gonna try to solve your problem. So what I will do, I will not
go. Import merge option will come, sir.
Yes, merge. File, import, and then merge.
Okay.
Merge will not change anything on my current file. This will be as it is. New file will be merged with my current file. Nothing will be changed. So merge.
Okay, sir.
But I have a different option. This one is just drag and drop. Just drag and drop here and then import file. And I got my file over here. Top. I will bring to center perspective.
This the perspective is angle, I have to bring it center, sir.
Yeah, I will go to top view. And here I will see where my center point is. And then I will drag my this CAD file near to my center point and press P for perspective, and I came
in. How to see the top view, sir?
TT.
T.
Keyboard T. I will just write it down for you. To see the top view of 3D model, of 3D model. So Sikran, if you have any doubt, you ask. Okay,
sure.
It's okay, little bit advanced. This is just to solve her query, and then we'll continue with the basic things. So we press T, alphabet T from keyboard, to see the top view. And I think this will goes for every other view also, to see the perspective. We press P, right view, we press R for left view, sorry, R is for V plus R. You have to press V and then you have to press R. V and then first press V alphabet and then press R, or you have to select right view. Then right view. And for left, it's L. It's alphabet L. Clear so far, both of you?
Yeah.
Okay. So here I am. Second thing is you have to see the measurement. Is this measurement is correct or not? This is just for Priyanka. This is just for Priyanka, not for Sasikiran. We will discuss about it. Priyanka, when you import anything, first check whether this measurement is correct or not. Create a box. This will be, should be, suppose it should be of 3 feet distance. My door should be 3 feet of distance. Let's see which angle. This is width. It should be 3 feet. 3 feet. You see 3 feet is so big. and my this came so small, so you have to scale it out. You have to scale it out. So I'm just quickly doing this until it reached this 3 feet. Suppose I got my 3 feet. So this is the actual measurement of your AutoCAD, right, Priyanka? Okay, so I'm continuing from here. If you have anything to ask, then ask. Okay, so this is the measurement, this is the final measurement of my AutoCAD. Now I have to start drawing the walls. So I have to create the wall with the help of box. Just create on box, and here it will not gonna like snap properly because we are doing with box. If you do with any other, I will tell you the another method also to modeling, but it will be exact only. This will, you don't have any much problem. Just click at the corner and create a box, and then give it a height W. Go to property modifier.
If we selected the corner itself.
No, you don't have to select the corner of the AutoCAD plan.
Okay, sir.
You don't have to select the corner of AutoCAD plan. It is just for measuring purpose. It will just give you measurement. It will just a guideline. You can adjust your box, your model later on after modeling also. I will tell you another method to make it exact as per the reference image, but as of now, if you create with the help of box, you don't have to be exact like on the measurement. If you can a little bit away from the measurement, then also it work. It will not create any problem. Just create a wall, adjust it from here, or I will tell you with the help of iTable Poly. Today we'll discuss how we can convert in iTable Poly and create the wall. Clear, Priyanka?
Yes, sir.
So I hope your problem will be solved from this.
Yes, sir.
Okay, try out this, and today's class will continue this modifying
doors
the and doors and window, and then we will follow this AutoCAD plan to create the wall and other things.
Okay, sir.
The basic things will continue from here.
Okay.
So as of now, I will keep these extra things in layers. I will create my layers quickly over here, and I will click on plus sign. See what I am doing. I am selecting the extra parts which I as of now I don't need. Select everything, click on the plus sign, and new layer is created, and I will write it extra. Means I don't need as of now. I can switch off the eyes of that layer and it will be invisible. Okay, so here we were in last class. So we have to create door and window. Let's first bring that image, my reference image. You will get my reference image, this one. Okay, we will bring this one, and with the help of this image, we will create the detailing of doors and window. Clear, both of you?
Yes.
Okay, try to do it along with me if possible. I will do it very properly, slowly, and so that you can continue doing with me. I go to file, and I will select view image file, and here I will browse my reference image, which is this first one. Open. I will bring it left side, small, scale it out and adjust a bit. This much is okay. So for the base is done. This one is also okay. Only thing is left with the door and window, and over here we have some different slight detailing over here. No, over the roof I have some details which we gonna see how we can make that. Okay, first we will make door. door will be over here. Now one new option I would like to show to both of you, that is isolate. Shortcut key is Alt plus Q. Isolate means tell me.
Isolate means Alt plus.
Isolate means only the selection object will be visible and everything else will be hidden. You know, in general talking, we say isolate this person, isolate this thing, means keep it away from other things. No, I will quickly write down the shortcut. What I did, yes, isolate. No, isolate 3D object. What we did, all plus Q. This is the shortcut to isolate or keep it separate from other 3D object. Clear?
Yeah.
I will do it once again, no problem. So first you have to select that particular object which you want to work with. Okay, you want to concentrate on only this particular model. So I have to isolate it from other models. I do not want to see other models, so that I can concentrate only on this model. So I will press Alt plus Q on my keyboard and see all other model is hidden. Now I can work with my this important model with it's here. Okay, fine. Okay, so here I have to modify this shape, because here if I have to cut anything or make a hole in it, I have to go further modification, for which I need editable poly. I go to modifier tab. Over my right we have create tab, we had modify tab. We have to go modifier tab and there is a modifier list. Click on the modifier list and select editable poly, press E and keep on pressing E until you get edit poly and click on edit poly. So edit poly modifier is added on top of your selected object. This in my case it is a box, and now edit poly give me some options like vertices. If I zoom here, you see a dot over here, no, blue color dot. Okay, now if I select this dot, I can modify the shape
by sir, selecting how, sir, editable poly modify list, sir?
Yeah, go to modifier list and there press alpha E until you get edit poly, until you see edit poly. Press
edit mesh.
Yes.
Ah, okay, sir. Edit poly.
Edit poly. Click on the edit poly button.
Okay, sir. Click it, sir.
Yeah, do it. And so, Sasikaran, you also try to do that.
Yeah.
And if possible, both of you share your screen, Priyanka. I would. If possible, so that I can see if you are doing any kind of mistake, or so that I can guide you.
Okay, sir.
Yes, do it. Do it. I told Polly.
On balance.
I told Polly and click on the vertices. Below you see selection option is there.
By vertex.
Yes, vertices, edges, border. And there you got polygon. There are multiple selection option we have. I'm going to explain you how this will help us in modifying the object.
It's not selected.
One second, no?
Not selecting.
Alright, okay. Second.
Click on the vertices. Click on the vertices. Yes. Click there.
Not selected.
Okay, I can see your box, this white line I'm not able to see. Can you see on my computer screen this white border which I'm having? Why can't it is not there on Sasikaran's model?
What's the reason?
Okay.
Edit poly.
Yeah, now Sasikaran got it. Sasikaran, you got vertices? See the yellow dots are there at all your corner of your models. Just click there. Click on that corner. Yes, W, press W. Press W, try to move. Click and move on any direction. Sasikaran, click and yes, click on direction, XYZ axis. Yes, click and drag. Yes, Sasikaran, yes. Try to move that. Yes, correct. And Priyanka, let me see your screen. You got it?
Yeah.
Priyanka,
which one I have to select, sir?
Click on the vertices. Vertices.
Not selecting.
Actually, your computer screen is getting blurred, so I'm not able to see the option. Can you zoom? Okay. Move your cursor up. Can you move your cursor up a bit? Yes. Little down. There you see selection. Little down. Move your cursor down. Yes.
Selection first.
Click on selection. Up, selection. Little below. Yes. Click there. You see? Yeah, below. Just little below. There's vertices. Little up. Little bit up. Move your cursor up. Your cursor little bit up. You see there is some icons. Just click over there. Yes. Vertices is there.
Okay.
That is vertices, no?
Yes, sir.
Now go to your model. Go to your model. You see the edge of your model? You see small dot, zoom in there.
Small dot, blue color.
Yes, click there, select that. Yeah, move that. Left click and drag it. Yes, try to move that. You see, you can modify the shape, right?
Yes, sir.
Try to move in different directions. X axis, Y axis, Z axis. Yes, correct. You're doing good. Yes, Priyanka, you're doing good. Sasikaran, try to select and move the vertices in different directions. Try other vertices. Yes, correct. Yeah, exactly. Okay. So this is what I'm trying to, you know, explain over here. So both of you has understood this, right?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Okay, I will continue from here. See, whenever I will work on any my model, you see a white border. You can see over here. I'm trying to zoom it and try to show this. See my computer. You see this white border? This white border indicate that my model is selected or highlighted.
Okay.
This will appear only on selected object. If it is not there, that means your object is not selected. If suppose I go outside, you see it is not selected, no? I will not get any modification option. Over my right, you see there is blank. So if you not get any modification option, then do not worry. That means you have not selected the object. You have to click and select the object, then you will get the modification options. Clear, both of you?
Yes.
Click, have to select the object.
Select the object, 3D object.
Okay, sir.
Then
okay.
Only you will get all the modification properties of the object. Simple?
Okay,
fine. So, let me continue from here. So, now we have seen vertices. Once again, I will click on vertices. I got this vertices with me. So, all of we have seen how to modify with the help of vertices. Now, beside vertices, there is edges. If I click here, I am seeing nothing. After vertices, right, toward my right.
Edges, sir.
Yes, click on edges.
Yes, sir.
So, on my model, the edges are not visible right now. Press F4.
F4,
yes, function key. Maybe on keyboard you have to select function key plus F4. You see this white line at the edge of my model?
Yes.
This should be appear on your model as well. Both of you, Priyanka and Sasikiran, this should be appear on both of your models.
Not appearing.
Just let me see your computer screen.
Function plus F4,
do it. You have laptop, right?
Sir?
Yeah. In laptop, function plus F4.
Function
key you have, function key near the space bar somewhere.
Next.
Yes, sir. Function plus
F4.
F4, sir.
Can you see white line? Zoom your model.
Yes, it's not fun.
Zoom your model a bit.
A white line is coming,
no? I can see a little bit of white line is coming, no? Try to select that. Both of you try to select that line. Click on that line. Can you able to select that line?
Yeah.
Click and move it. As you had moving vertices, now try to, yeah, Priyanka, correct. Click and move it on different axis. Yes, correct. Do it. Yes. Select the edge and try to move that edge. Yes, try to do that one or two times. Yes, a second, you also try to do it one, two times. Be like comfort. Yes. Select different edges. Press Control key and select multiple edges. You can select multiple edges by pressing Control key. Yes, good. All right. Okay, fine, both of you?
Yes, sir.
It's clear, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I will do it in my computer screen also. See, I press F4. I will just write it down over here also. I think F3, wireframe, F4. See, I have already written for another student. You can see my computer screen. I will zoom it a bit.
To see
the edge hide and hide model, we have to press F4. FUNCTION function. If you are using a laptop, then function plus F4. Okay. Okay.
Yes.
Other thing we will gonna explain later on. First, focus only on F4, only the edges. Okay. Now, with the help of, I can modify. Later on, I will tell you how to modify. You see, I can modify the shape. I will move my camera, and you see, I can create any kind of shape from here with just help of edge. See?
Okay, sir.
See how I modified it? I just move it on one direction and I can modify the shape of my model with just selecting the edge. Try to do this. Take your time. Yeah, do it. Click on one direction, X, Y, Z, any axis, and try to move that. Click one axis. Sasikiran, click one edge. You are selecting multiple edges. Click outside and click on one edge. Yes. Click there. Simple left click.
Click.
Simple left click on top of that edge. It's not working or what?
No.
Okay. Then click and drag. Click outside and drag. See if you can select. Click outside and drag.
No.
Sir, I'm not getting it. Sir.
Okay. It needs a little practice. No problem. See.
Sir, this triangle house, sir. Just tell me, sir. How
okay.
You got?
See, I'll do it once again. See. I'll do control Z. Okay, both of you see to my computer screen. Both of you see my computer screen. See. Okay. I will click on my model. And iTable poly is applied on my model.
Yes,
I will
sir.
Go to edge over here. Edge key. I will press edge key. I will click on one edge. You see my edge is highlighted. It's getting the red color. Now I will move my edge on one direction, x axis. I have to move my edge only on one direction. I will click on x axis and I will drag it inside like this. Little bit. I will repeat the same thing with another side, another edge. Click on edge and I will drag it inside my model. And this shape I got it. Try to make this shape. Both of you try to make this shape. See my computer screen, try to make this shape. Sasikaran, what if you're not able to do not delete that box and create new box? Create new box. Yes, create new box. Go to modifier, select, go to modifier, select editable poly. Go to modifier list. Yes, select editable poly. Press E, alphabet E. You got edit poly. Yes, click that. Click on the edges. Yes. Click. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, you got it. Do it. Try to make this. Priyanka, you also. If you're not able to do, delete the thing, create new thing and do it from fresh. Do it from start.
Priyanka, okay,
sir. Yeah, you got it. Yeah, you got it. Nice, nice, nice. Looking good.
Correct.
Looking
sir.
Nice. Yes, correct, correct. So you got have now confidence, you can do it?
Yes, sir, I can do it, sir.
Yeah, nice, nice, good. I have seen Sasikaran also doing well. Yeah, started do it from other side. Yeah, exactly, correct. Yeah, good Sasikaran.
Thank you.
Okay, so both of you see my computer screen. I will continue from here. So we have seen vertices. Simple
edges.
Yes.
Edges.
We have seen edges. Now we border we will skip as of now. Border we will discuss later on.
Okay,
after
sir.
After
okay.
That we have polygon.
Okay, sir.
Now polygon, if I click on polygon, I can select the face. You can see complete face.
Yes, sir.
Click anywhere, like on top, and try to move it height. Adjust the height of my model. Click on the top. Adjust the height of my model. Do it.
Polygon.
Yes. Yes. Try to move on one axis. Select any axis. X, Y or Z. Try to move it. Yes.
Okay, sir.
Select another face. Maybe top. Or the left side or right side, yes. Try to move up and down. Move
and down.
On Z axis. Blue
like
one.
This, sir?
Yes, correct. Correct, correct.
Okay, sir.
Yes, correct. Do it. Continue doing it. Select another face. Priyanka, select another face. Maybe front one. Maybe front face or back face.
Okay, sir.
And move that. And Sasikaran, you also. Yes, yes. Yes, try to move up and down, left and right. Just try to move it out. Yes, correct. Good. Okay. Okay, so both of you are now confident with this?
Yes. Okay.
Okay, I will continue from here. Okay, so next is your element. After polygon, we have element with me. So it will select everything. If I click on the model, it will select everything. You see, everything is become red.
Element.
Yes, click on the element and click on the object. You see all the faces connected thing, na? All the connected vertices, all the connected edges are like together they form an element. Later on we will discuss multiple elements. There are multiple elements. Right now we have only one element with us. Clear? Priyanka, do it.
Okay.
Click on the element option and click on the model.
Yes, sir. Click, sir.
Yes, try to move that selection, move that model. You can see everything is moving all together.
Yes, sir.
Okay, this means that all the vertices, all the faces are one element. Everything is interconnected. It means that. Clear?
Okay.
Okay. Now again, we will come to vertices. Actually, this is not my top portion. This is where the wall should be, the door should be. So I will do Control Z. This is just to, or do one thing. Or we can do one thing. We will delete this editable poly. Okay. Go little bit top. You see. Remove modifier from the stack. You see my computer screen? You see my computer screen?
Okay.
There is a recycle bin. Small recycle bin option is there. It says remove it, no? Recycle bin option is there, recycle bin icon. Click on that recycle bin and I will get my base shape. Everything will be deleted. Little bit left. Sasikan, little go top. Yes, little bit right. Sasikan, right. Yes, see the recycle bin icon. Yes, click on that. Click.
Yeah,
you got original shape, no? And Priyanka, let me see your screen.
Remove, sir. Actually, I removed.
Yeah, you done it, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you got it, no? So this is how editable poly can be removed. Okay, once again we will take editable poly. Take once again editable poly. Go to modifier list, press E until you get editable poly. Select editable poly.
Yes, sir.
And this time we will create the door.
Okay.
We have seen the selection option, vertices, edges. To create the door, we need edges. You see, I don't have any edges over here to make the gap.
Sir, I have one doubt, sir. You are just rotating the three sides, no, sir. How, sir?
With the help of Alt key and my middle mouse.
Okay, okay.
Press Alt key and middle mouse. Click and drag it out.
Alt
key plus middle mouse button, click and drag.
You just do it, sir. I'll see.
Oh. See.
Alt
key and
plus that middle button. If
the scroll button,
it's not coming for me. Alt. I am good.
Try to do it. Sasikan, you also do that, huh?
Yeah.
Click Alt and middle mouse button and just drag it out and try to move your viewport. Click. Yes, correct. Sasikan is doing it well. Yes. Priyanka, let me see. Yeah, do it.
Yeah.
I'm not able to see your screen.
Yes, sir.
हाँ चलो डू इट,
हैं।
हाँ प्रेस ऑल्ट एंड मिडिल माउस क्लिक एंड ड्रैग।
जैसे मैं
यस करेक्ट, यस करेक्ट करेक्ट करेक्ट। ओके नाइस नाइस नाइस, गुड गुड। ओके वी विल कंटिन्यू फ्रॉम हियर। सो वी हैव टू क्रिएट दिस डोर, तो आई नीड सम एजेस। एस आई जस्ट जूम इन दिस इमेज, नो लेट मी शो यू द इमेज। If I zoom in, you both have images. Try to open that image. You see, there is an edge over here, no? Just the size of the door, there is an edge. So I need this edge, no? To create this gap, entrance gap for my door, I need this extra edge over here, no? Which is missing on my case, no? So I need extra edge. So I will create the edge over here. I will select, click outside and drag it like this. All my edges is selected right now.
Yes, sir.
I will do it once again. I click outside and drag and select all my edges. Try to select all the edges. First, move your model a little bit where you can see the front portion. And click only this front line, not the side one. Only this front line. I repeat, not the side edges, only this front edges, this one. Yes, yes, yes. And then right click on top of your model, and there you will see connect option. You have to click on this small button over here. Connect option. This is just to add an edge over here. You have to go to connect and there is a small button over here, connect. You have to click on this small button. See connect.
Where click is on. It?
See, connect, connect.
All right, yes, one second.
Connect. Yes, yes, yes. Just be there. Priyanka, you got it?
No, sir.
Just see my computer screen. There is a connect option and there is a small button just left side of connect. Just click on that button.
No, sir. First, I have to select them.
First, select all the edges and then right click. Right click.
All the edges. Then right click.
And there is an option connect. Left side, you have an option connect.
No, sir.
Can I see your computer screen? Yeah, just see me, show me your computer screen.
Have to select, sir.
First of all, zoom in. It is very small. First, zoom your model. Isolate your model. Come on, isolate. Alt plus Q.
Alt plus?
Q, Q.
Okay, sir.
Okay, rotate your model. So that you can see the front portion, rotate your model.
Just a minute.
Alt plus middle mouse. Press Alt and then middle mouse button. Rotate your model. Yes, yes, yes.
Correct.
Yeah, that's right. Now okay. You have selected the edge. Edge option is selected on the modifier.
You have to select it. In modifier list, you have to select
this. Modifier list, edge should be activated. Selection on modifier list, edges should be activated.
Okay, sir.
And then click and drag on your model. On your model, left click and drag.
Left click, connect, yes, sir. Connect option is there, sir.
Yes, you got. You have to click.
Connect, sir.
There's a small icon box on connect option. There's a small box. Toward left. No. Connect only. Left. Go left. Little bit. Yeah. Small box. Click there. You get connection option. You got, no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Just hold down, huh? And Sasikiran, just look, I'm just see my computer screen, both of you. Huh? See, I'm doing once again, selecting all my edges, right click and connect option. That small box will give you additional options. And here you will get number of connections you want. The first one is number of edges. You see, if you increase that, try to do that with me. Increase the number of edges. You see multiple edges appearing. Both of you try to do that. We need only two.
Sir, for me it's not appearing.
Your edges may be deselected. Try to select all the edges. Try to escape, cancel that. Bottom you will see cross. Bottom you will see there's a small cross. Just cross it out and do it once again.
Sir, for me.
Yes, select all the edges. Click and drag, select all the edges.
Yes, sir, all the edges.
And then right click.
Right click, connect, sir.
Connect options. Increase
the coming cross. For me, coming cross, sir.
You have selected another edges at the corner edges also. Don't select corner, only the center edges. Cross that. Bottom is a cross option. Cancel that. Yes, click outside. Click.
This, sir, I have.
Click outside. Deselect everything. Now only the front edges. You see only the front edges.
This one, sir.
Yes, select all the edges.
Only front edges.
I mean all the front four edges, four corners.
How to select the four corners in at a time, sir?
Click and drag. See, look at my computer screen. Look at my computer screen. My cursor is outside and I'm just clicking and dragging it out. Click and drag. Click and drag. Only straight. Click and drag. Got it? I will tell you a different option to select that. Okay? Sasikiran, just have a look, okay? I'm trying to tell you a different options.
Okay, sure.
What you have to do, select one edge. Select one edge over here. Both of you, can you both see my computer screen?
Yes.
Okay, Priyanka?
Sir, it is correct, sir.
Yeah, you got it. Yes, right, you got it. Anyway, just see the computer screen. I will tell you one different option to selection. Priyanka, just see my computer screen, okay? You able to see my computer screen?
Yes, sir, I can see, sir.
Okay, do it once again. Select outside to deselect everything. Click outside so that everything deselected. Make sure your selection is edge over my modifier. Selection should be edge, and here on my model I will select one edge. I will not drag, I will select one edge. And on my modifier I have an option called ring, R-I-N-G, ring. Over my modifier there is a ring. If I click on ring, all my edges will be selected. You see
ring, R
ring, just press on ring.
Where's the ring option?
On my modifier,
okay.
There is a ring option. It will help you to select all the edges.
Okay, sir.
And then you can right click and apply same thing, connect with the small box.
Okay, sir.
So both of you are okay so far?
Yeah.
Yes,
confidence about this?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay, try to practice this. I will go little further. I have selected two, okay? Two of my edges I needed. I selected two. And below two is just that distance between the edges, you see? My edge, the distance between the edges is moving. try to do it. Below 2, there is an option where I can change the distance between the edges. Click on the triangle. Subsequent, try to click on the small triangles. Click and drag. Yes, small triangle, just click and drag. I think your selection is lost. Subsequent, you have to make selection again. You see, your edges are not selected. Select the edges once again and repeat the same thing. Yes, select the edges once again and repeat the same step. First one is for number of edges, how many edges you need. Second is the distance between the edges, how much wide or narrow edges you want. Third is the position of the edges, where you want, which position, toward my left, toward my right. Try to do this. Try to use all three options. Do it. Priyanka, you also do that? Take only two edges. Yes, try to move all the options and see how to adjust the edges. All this will help you to adjust your edges. You have deselected that. Cancel that. Do not select, do not click outside. Do not click outside or this will be deselected.